Audio check. Video check. Audio check. Video check. All right. We have audio. We have video. Hello, everyone. I am Blazar Gaming. Playing World of Warcraft, Battle for Azeroth expansion. Last night, we went on a heroic raid attempts, number two. And I thought I'd show you some of that footage this morning. We had a couple failed Talic attempts, and then we had a successful attempt, the third one, which is what we are viewing right now, third attempt Talic. I came in seventh in DPS. We only had 8 DPSers, 2 tanks, 4 healers. 4 healers, 2 tanks. So I came in second to last in DPS at 6.2, just behind the other elemental shaman. And in damage taken, I was 10th out of the 14 of us. So I came in 7th in DPS, 14th in damage taken. So I'm still doing pretty well avoiding damage. Of course, that could just mean that I didn't get many whatever that blood stuff's called that makes you run away and drop blood on the ground. But let's look. It starts at 1721. Here we go. This is heroic. So I'm popping my cooldowns. I guess that's where they're supposed to drop the blood. I'm just glad it wasn't on top of me. Make sure I'm nowhere near. Stay in the healing range. Fifth in DPS right now. I didn't avoid. I wanted to stay over there in the same place with the other blood, but there was a player over there. So I turned around and went back the other way. There was a player standing over there. So I moved back over to where the group was. I've dropped to 7th in DPS. Elemental Shamans don't do DPS while moving. Our Flame Shock will tick. That's about it. Our rotation's very simple. You keep Flame Shock up, because it causes Lava Burst to crit. And then you do your Lava Bursts as long as you have Lava Bursts. When you don't have Lava Burst, your filler is Lightning Bolt. But every time you hit 90 on your resources, you do an Earth Shock. So that's pretty much it. You keep Lava Shock, Flame Shock. You keep Flame Shock up on the target. You do all your Lava Bursts. You hit Earth Shock when you're above 90 resources, and you fill with Lightning Shock, Lightning Bolt. That's it. Now I do have two cooldowns I can use. That's my Fire Elemental and Ascendance. Oh, you keep your totems up. They have 2-minute cooldowns. So every time I have to move, it destroys my DPS. And we got it. I healed myself up, and I got nothing. Got nothing. Like I said, I ended up 7 out of 8 DPSers. Need to try to not move around so much that fight. And end up 10th on damage taken. And I got the red blood stuff pretty often. Got it 3 or 4 times. So next, we one-shot Mother. That was a accidental pull and reset. But we one-shot Mother. This again is on heroic. Came in 7th again in DPS. We seem to have picked up an extra person. These names are different. Let me go back to Talik. Maybe it's... we did get one extra person. These are our 8 DPSers. Hunter... Warrior, Warlock, Monk, Druid, Shaman, Mage. We got a Rhett Paladin. So we picked up a new guy. Some more DPS. There's our healing. And damage taken, I was 10th again. So I'm consistent. 7th in DPS, 10th in damage taken. Let's see how that looks. This one is 3740. Remember, every time I have to move, that destroys my DPS because of all my long casts. Okay, this was our first attempt. It wasn't a bad pull. It was a missed interrupt. I completely forgot about that. Too many of the, well, let's see exactly what happened. Everything was going real smooth there for a second. Healers are keeping up. We've had a few people go through, see all the blobs, but I think they went through too close together. I think that's what happened. You need to stagger when you go through. All right, nobody's going through yet. They'll go start after the first wind. And there was the wind. So there goes the first guy through. And the second guy through. Third guy through. So there's three blobs over there. Three. Fourth guy through. Fifth guy through. And then right here, we got the, they missed an interrupt and it wiped the raid. So he changed the groups around a little bit. Let me back up. He changed the groups around, asked me to go in pretty close to after the first group does. Because I've got a capacitor totem. The bad thing about the capacitor totem is the blobby guys spawn as soon as you go through the barrier.
Ahoy!
Let me make sure this is. As soon as you go through the barrier, the blobby guys, well, they don't spawn, but a red spirit thingy will spawn and walk towards the middle of the room. Then in the middle of the room, they turn into the red blob, the red blood, and then want to start casting. The capacitor totem, when you cast it, it delays 2 seconds before it stuns, AOE stuns. So you have to guess when the blobs are going to come out of their walking phase and turn into their blobby phase. And cast your totem before that happens, because you have to guess. And then hope they all come out. And then you stun them. You hope, it's like winning the lottery. You have to hope, you know exactly, you have to guess when they're going to turn into a blob and start casting. And cast your capacitor totem before they do that. So this time they were better at staggering going through the gate. They didn't get all their blobs at once. Now there's two people went through and then I went through. But at this point, I threw my capacitor totem out and got them. I stunned 3 of them right there. We would have been in big trouble if that capacitor totem hadn't hit those guys. Maybe. Somebody else could have stunned them too. But like I said, it was just a complete roll of the dice. Whether you actually get those guys stunned or not. So now the worst part's over. And after this, we didn't have much issue. We've got 2 that'll be turning into a blob soon. So there they go. They turn into a blob. We DPS'd them. Pretty quickly. We got so many DPSers over here that they're not an issue anymore. It's just that very initial group that has a tough time. Now again, I don't really know if it was my capacitor totem that stunned them. It could have been one of the monks. Because you've got that 2 second delay before it goes off. So far, everybody's still alive. Again, every time I have to move, that destroys my DPS. I'm not even on the DPS board right now. not in the top eight. Only have flame shot ticking. Now I do need to use my ascendance and fire elemental more. But I'm probably saving them for room three. Alright, so we got people working their way through the... I forgot about the lasers there, but they didn't kill me. They should have, but they didn't. Got some people awful close to the blood, I mean to the fire. I was about to go through because he wants me between one groups one and two. But when this came out, I had to quickly make a decision. Now, I was premature on my totem there. Right now, but we did okay. Ooh, we've got two people down. See, when I came through the barrier, I threw out my totem, and I really should have paid more attention to there was only one blob. And then a few seconds later, there were bunches of blobs. So I could have saved my capacitor totem. But we made it through it. I think we've lost a third person now. After missing that one beam, I've gotten better about the beams. Trying to get out of the fire, trying to stay away from the boss. See, this is where I said, this is chaos. Because I can't do any DPS with all this moving. My Shadow Priest would be so much better because of all the dots. The dots keep ticking even when I'm moving. I was too slow getting out of the fire, but again, I took no damage for some reason. Not complaining, it's just bugs in the encounter. I've had two bugs save me this encounter. I got nothing. Oh, I'm resin. I'm resing the other one. Nope. Didn't need it anymore. I got nothing. Nothing. I got nothing. So I finished 7th in DPS. 10th in damage taken. The other shaman must have been one of the dead people, as was the druid. All right. Then we had some attempts on the fetid devourer. I think we're going to look at the last attempt. Don't remember which one I pulled up in. The Fetid Devourer. We've got a DPS issue on the Fetid Devourer. You've got to every now and then he spawns two tumors. And if you don't DPS them down quickly, then he'll eat them and heal back. He'll heal, not back, but he'll heal for the same amount of health that the tumors still have. So if the tumor starts off with, I'm just making numbers up, 1 million health, and you DPS it to 0, he can't eat it. But if you DPS it down to where there's only 100K health left, then when the devourer comes over and devours it, he'll get 100K healing. That's how it works. So your best bet is to DPS race the tumors down as quickly as possible. In normal, it's no big deal because the tumors don't have a lot of health. And when he does devour one, he doesn't heal very much. But in heroic, he heals a whole lot. I've been watching another guild every now and then working on him in mythic, and they're having the same problem. They've been working on him for days and days and days and days, whatever, weeks and weeks and weeks, because they've got to DPS those bloods down, because when he eats one of those tumors, he heals back to full and you start all over again. Then you get the next two tumors. If you don't get them down, he heals back to full again. So in mythic, they're really having a time. But we're in heroic. And we're at the same issue they are in mythic. So, on this last attempt, I was 6th in DPS. Not sure what happened to our druid. Or a mage. And a rogue. They're probably all capable of better DPS than that. And I took 11th. So I moved up one, even though that's pretty low. Where'd our other shaman go? Oh, way down here. So I went up to 6th and down to 11th. Fetid Devourer 134.53. All right. He put these DPSers in this group and me and these DPSers in this group. He said, for them to take the left tumors, us to take the right tumors. So we're racing to get our tumor down, they're racing to get their tumor down. I've moved up to third in DPS because I blew all my cooldowns to get him down as far as possible. There's our first knockback. In Heroic, you get knocked back often, which again destroys my DPS. I'm still up in third place, but that's because of blowing all my cooldowns at the beginning. And now we're going to go over and we're going to the right. I told you we take the right ones. The other five take the left one. Though it looks like we got a whole lot more people on this one. And we took it down quickly. And then this one had no, yeah, for some reason everybody was on the same tumor. Oh, but we already got two DPSers down for some reason. And you see he, well, no, he didn't heal back completely. But I don't know why we're losing people. Why people are dying. Because now we're down three DPSers. Yeah, we had no chance of getting this tumor down. And he healed up, and then yeah, he healed way up. The first two tumors we did very well. But then I don't know what killed all those people. But from that point on, there was no way. We could have called a wipe after those three people went down. I guess he just wanted us to practice. Now, he comes over to eat it. And he's back to full health. I didn't realize we'd had people down, DPSers down. So, the issue on that fight was people getting killed. I don't think it had anything to do with our rotations in DPS. It was people dying. So at this point, he decided that we would go back to normal. So I switched to my Shadow Priest, but he told me he wanted me to get to stay on my Shaman and work on my rotation. The guy has a restoration Shaman that he raids with another raid group. So, I think he knows what an elemental shaman's rotation is, since his main is a restoration shaman. Maybe he doesn't. But he asked me to stay on my shaman and work on my rotation, which, as I said earlier, is one of the easiest rotations in the game. You keep flame shock up. You hit lava burst when it's available. You hit Earth Shock when you hit over 90 of your resource, and Filler with Lightning Bolt. So, at that point, I began contemplating if I was in the right guild or not. So, I stayed on my Shaman. I'll still think about the guild. I can contemplate that. So, we went back to Talik again. Came in 7th in DPS. 12th in damage taken. And this one is 145-47. Here we go. So, back to the same three bosses, this time on normal. Avoided the Sanguine. Avoided the Cauldral Drop. To get out of the Bloods. Shaman's DPS is all RNG. The rotation is simple. The RNG comes in with Lava Surge. When does Lava Surge proc? Giving you an instant cast. Lava Burst. So I keep tabbing here, looking for the next spot, the next ad. There it is. And tabbing again, looking for the next ad. There it is. I didn't mind absorbing that one glob. They don't do a lot of damage on normal. That one absorbed that one. Last thing you want it to do is to go interrupt a healer. So I don't mind standing in front of him. There I am. There I am complaining about him not letting me play my Shadow Priest on normal mode.
Stay on our mains.
Work on our rotations. Shaman, elemental shamans have no rotation. You keep flame shock up. Movement is our enemy because of our long cast lava bursts and lightnings. So that was Talak normal. Then we did Mother normal. I finished 8th in DPS this time. Out of 9 DPSers. And didn't take a lot of damage, but 6th on the list. So let's go see what that was about. 154.32. So my stun went off and got those two oozes. Just talking about how he asked me, even though I'm in group two, to go in between group one and two because of my capacitor totem stun. Which has a 1 minute cooldown. So I came through, stunned the first two. I think that time I dropped it just a little too early. Again, you have to predict when they're going to change from walking to casting because of the 2 second delay. Now, normal, it's not that big a deal. On a heroic, you want to try to get those stuns timed perfectly, and it's RNG. You have to guess. So I got my totem cast. It blew up, but they're already dead. I forgot. Forgot the lasers, but they don't do enough damage to kill you in normal. My casts are too long to do any good on DPSing those globs. Before one of my casts go off, the blobs are already dead. I can get a flame shock off, but it's got a 6 second cooldown. And it's a dot. Everybody else DPSs it down before it ticks. Even ticks two times probably. And that was Mother. And I did get an upgrade for my... I forgot to pause that. And I got an upgrade, so... I got a 360 hands, replaced a 335 purple hands, So it turned out, because of RNG, I actually got an upgrade on my shaman. So that kind of cooled my anger down a little bit. Let's see what he's giving away today. What you giving away today? Nothing. Just stuff to sell.
Tell me of your troubles. There is no hurry.
Alright, and then the last fight. The Fetid Devourer. I'm last in DPS. You know, 9. With 7.9k. And 10th in damage taken. Let's go see what my issue... Probably didn't get many Lava Surge procs. RNG. How long was this fight? 2 minutes and 53 seconds? Yep. There was a a trash mob, the great big tall guys. Single target that I did 14k DPS on. Of course, it was a shorter fight. But it's because I got more Lava Surge procs. This one, I probably didn't get many Lava Surge procs. I made it up to 4th place in DPS because I popped my cooldown. There was a Lava Surge instant cast, Lava Burst. Getting in position to go shoot the Bloods. I had to move. So let's get this blood instead. Brought my totems with me. Now, normal, we usually just do one of the tumors. But in heroic, we're going to have to do them both. So, I don't know why we don't practice that on normal. He's making us play our mains on normal. We should be practicing what we're supposed to be doing on heroic. And there it ended. So that was the raid. I don't know. All right. Complete 4 Azeroth world quests. I'll get 1,000 artifact power. Complete 4 world quests in Stormsong Valley. And get what? 200 war resources. All right, let me take a quick break. It's top of the hour. Get my water thermos, canteen, or whatever it's called. I'll be right back. All right. Let's... let's go do that Azeroth quest in Stormsong Valley. Actually, Zoldazar, Nazmir, Voldoon, Zoldazar, Nazmir, Voldoon. Why does it think they're all over there? Wasn't there one over here in Stormsong Valley? I guess because I already had it selected. Complete 4 Azeroth world quests. Azeroth empowerment. Let's go see.
Good day to you.
Good day to you. So my item level is 351 now. Because of that one little upgrade of 25 points. Still have a blue trinket.
Azeroth nearby, and something drawing a great deal of power from it. You need to stop it.
So I need to do 4 world quests in Stormsong.
Area. I need you to take out whoever is behind these attacks.
show them how we do things in
that was some severe server lag. Severe lag. I cast a spell and 3 seconds later it goes off. What else to do over here? Taja the Tide Howler. Speak to Collector Tojo. What is today? Monday? Tomorrow's server maintenance.
My brethren have wrought. End this creature's misery.
Song will endure. Remember.
To train needs to be at least 2 centuries old. I've collected many things over the years. See if you can match them. Ah, good, an adventurer. In need of your services.
All right. Mech. Fire. Gem. Wisp. Mech. Jaws. Bat. Gem. Fire. Jaws. Wisp. Oops. It's this one. Spike. Pirate. Pirate. Spike. Bat. Go pick up my 200 war resources. What is that? Oh.
Tides welcome you. May the sea carry you safely.
That was 1500 rep with Storm's Wake. Very nice. Alright. Now all of these are in Zoldazar. I can go do that. No. There's the Champions of Azeroth.
We will not falter.
I don't need any orders of embers. Rep. There's some easy war resources. I think I got a couple thousand war resources. I don't remember. I'll do these two here. Here's another one. I'll do these two here. that whole fight with the big mech when I was in the group in the raid, it was all messed up, lag and everything.
Good day to you.
Glory to House Wickman.
91 gold. Yeah, I guess I could have, if I'd thought about it. Too late. He's gone. Guess I gotta go up there after that big guy.
Thank you.
Aren't there any more of the big guys around anywhere? None of them have respawned. There's one. Any more big guys respawn? Yep. Yep.
Mind your business, and I'll mind mine.
I hope everyone's doing well today.
those who would seek to abuse it for their own ends. You've got to stop them.
Was a miscast, but it worked. So what are they guarding over here? I thought they were guarding a node. There it is. They covered it with all their bodies. Fifty-three percent. 84%. Guardian of the Spring. Strange looking unicorn thingy. Jaws, fire, spike, mech, gem, jaws. Pirate, fire. Nope, it's here. Should have gone with my first intuition. Spike. Wisp. Gem. Mech. That was just a lucky guess right there. Yeah, I think it's time to go to let's do this. Time to go to the other island.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Bits and bobs. Bits and bobs. Have some crackers. Salty crackers. Salty dog crackers. Alright. Recover Azeroth or do this guy. Definitely want to do the Tortolan. This just takes time. This would be quick. Either one of them would get me. This one and that one. This will be so much quicker than that one. Yeah, don't need that one at all. I don't need 7th Legion. If you remember, I am exalted with everyone except Proudmoore, Stormswake, and Tortolan. Not that Exalted gets me anything exciting, but we'll look once we hit. Now, if getting Exalted with all the factions in BFE gave you flight, that'd be cool. McGraw's here. I'll get all my turtles to the water and then they'll probably eat my sharks. Be swallowed up by predators of the ocean.
A turtle made it to the
They have a tough life. First, they've got to make it to the water, and then they got to survive to old age. They're not safe just because they're in the water. Draw McGraw. You're welcome. Now let me out of combat. Thank you.
A turtle made it to the water.
Thank you. I'm a wisp. I wonder how warm it's supposed to get up to today. I need to go out and put some air in my race car tires at some point. The cold weather is... made the tire pressure go down as usual. It's currently 44 Fahrenheit. It's supposed to reach 66 degrees and sunny. It's not bad. Not bad. 66 Fahrenheit. It'll be cooler in the parking garage. I've got a little air compressor that plugs into my Camaro port. I need to put about 4 pounds of pressure in each tire. Before I went to South Carolina a couple months ago, I pumped them up. I put air pressure in them. And it was warm, and they got up to 37 after heating up on the highway. But when the cold came, they dropped down to about 32. And I need them about 35 would be good. But since it's cooler weather, I'll put them at 36.
Someone's drawing power from Azeroth in this area. You need to stop them.
That's it.
If only they were using the power to heal Azeroth instead of hurt her.
That's it.
Yeah.
Holly Pop clapped excitedly for me. That's interesting. I guess because I got there at the last second and was able to accomplish my quest. So, I guess I turn this in with Silithus. Bronzebeard. Give me my 1,000 champions of 1,000 artifact power. I'm at 9049.
Azeroth cries out in pain. The world must be.
Now I'm at 10449. So I actually got 1,400 Azeroth power. We're all done here, right?
The world needs us, champion.
Yeah, we're all done here. Yeah, you know, while I was over there, I didn't look to see if there were more Tortolan quests, but that's okay. I am done with this guy.
Let us parley. Come back anytime.
Okay. When I come back from my break, it'll be Shadow Priest time. I left him over here. That's okay. We'll probably have stuff to do over here. Here's my shadow piece. 343. Eight numbers behind. Revered with everybody, exalted with nobody. Got the same stuff. So, I'm in Nazmir. My weakness is these are 3:30. These are 3:25 and 3:30. Everything else is purple. Of different magnitudes. Let's take on this guy. He's right around the corner. Get me some rep with the 7th Legion.
Unsavory creature, dispatch it for the Alliance.
Did they just finish him off? Because that would be annoying. There he is. I did the max DPS, or the most DPS, I should say. Uh-oh. Somebody soloing this guy over here or something? I think somebody was going to try and gave up. All right. See, I want to go all the way out there. I know this way best. Just gotta get up here and get to the main road that I'm most familiar with. the main road? Nope. Where is the main road? Oh, I'm almost to it. Can I get this without bugging that?
It's too far away.
Yeah. Here's the main road. Now, go up to the intersection, turn left, cut across by the tree, and I'll be there. I'll be there. There's no turtle quest out here, are there? No tortolans. There's no reason not to go do that. Can't think of any reason not to do that. Forgot the water's pretty shallow. Almost ran right past it. Uh-oh. Got a little deep there. Let's go around. Oh, I was wondering what was wrong. Where's Levitate? When I'm prepared to go raiding, I swap Levitate and health stones. So I'm popping my health stones trying to levitate. See him. Captain Merkel. Nope, that's not him.
Be careful. There's a threat nearby. Keep calm and strike it down before it can escape.
Let me click this first. That gives me 10% more mastery for 10 minutes.
Thank you.
where I started. Take the long run out to here. Those are all irrelevant. Just passing through. Just passing through. Not meant to be crocodile food, just passing through. When I'm moving along and I want to see what's to my right, I jump, rotate, rotate back. I do the same with the left. I jump, look left, and then rotate back. That way I don't lose any momentum. Jump, rotate, rotate back. I saw those trolls over there. I get to the main intersection, I go left. See that big tree up there? Well, I gotta avoid the patrol first. That big tree up there, I turn right. I cut corners. There's always somebody hanging out back there. I think if I do the quests over here, there's a flight path right there. And that would cut this distance off. I could fly right there and then run over here. I just have to do the quests out here.
Someone's drawing power from Azeroth in this area. You need to stop them.
I think I'm done in Nazmir. Let's check Voldoon real quick. See if I need to cross. Sometimes there's one here, but there's not. There's a Tortolan. Oh yeah, it's behind this island.
A Tortolan begins its life amidst great danger. Get these turtles here on the beach. Defend them as they
Quick draw, McGraw is here. Never fear. Tisto is here.
Made it to the water.
I think all the turtles made it to the water. Yep, they did not get a turtle. Seconds before I can blow the whistle. Can you imagine how beautiful this would be if it was on a 21st century game engine? If it looked more like Skyrim than it does Looney Tunes? I don't care that the characters are cartoony, but trees and water and flowers and leaves and sky and animals and stuff. Rock and stone and granite and marble and clay and 3D instead of 2D. Just passing through. No need to knock me off my horse. Just passing through. I could make those things, lots of those things, where you don't get dazed while mounted. I just don't ever think about it.
Drawing power from Azeroth in this area. You need to stop them.
That wasn't the dude I needed. It was just a bunch of other dudes. There's the dude I need. So close. Let's go check out this guy. Umbrella. Oh yeah, I went looking for him the other day and he seemed to be in the middle of a, maybe not. Maybe this is different. Okay, there's a road up to my left. Yeah, it seemed like this wanted to take me into an enemy town. And I don't want to go into an enemy town. Maybe not. Maybe I've got my... There's a sharp right turn right there I can take. Keep me from going into the enemy town. Just a spider. It's a hunter's pet that's tanking. Go out there. Oh, that's Zabala. Blow the whistle. That was a cool mount she had. Triceratops.
What has the wind brought?
Take me to Zildazar. Wait a minute. I could have done Bramblewing. See what happens if I push this button. Where does it take me? Because I want to do this one too. I think it's going to take me right to Zabala. That's okay. Then I'll come back and do this one. And then maybe that one. We'll just go where it takes me. Thank you.
guess I could plug in my iPad. I use my iPad to monitor my stream because my Twitch dashboard isn't always accurate. There's one. There's one. Somebody's cleared the path for me. Well, some of them. Sure.
just passing through. Don't mind the little gnome, just passing through.
Good day to you.
Good day to you. You know, I ought to too much trouble. I'll just leave it as it is. I was gonna switch these two, but that's all right. Keep a space in between Artifact Power and Kirin Tor Rep. Getting some annoying abdominal cramping.
Tortolian begins its life amidst great danger. Get these turtles here on the beach. Defend them as they make for the safety of the ocean. What aren't you a spry young thing?
Main reason I retired early was because of intestinal issues. Doctors can't find anything wrong. So they give it a generic name. Call it IBS. Quick Draw McGraw is here, never fear, little turtles. You're welcome.
A turtle made it to the water.
One more quest over here. Then we'll go back to Kirin Tor. Kirin Tor. Cold Terror. I don't know where I'm at. Cold Terran, I think. Bramblewing. Let's go see what a Bramblewing is. See if it's easy to get to. If it's not easy to get to, we'll hearth back.
Comes to this land as naturally as a choking vine. Cut it short and protect our troops.
Ah, okay. That's a bramble wing. In case he has a knockback, put myself against the wall over here. Why'd my camera view change? That's annoying.
Squares and
cultures
right here.
Right here.
Stop, Wade. What can I do
for you? What can I do for you? wonder why the colors keep changing on me. See, now it's pink. Now it's blue. Some kind of weird storm.
Travelers have been killed in this area. I need you to take out whoever is behind these attacks.
Now let's check this one out real quick. That's not the right road, this is the right road. There's a big star moss. Oh, he got interrupted. Ja the Tide Howler, Tortolan. Okay. Let's grab the flat path over here. There it is. Just trying to think. Where's this flight path? It's right here, other side of this bridge. Bee, bzz, 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 busy bee. All right, taking a break. I'll be back. My monitor in front of my lap. Recline my chair. Oh, too far. Alright. Let's go find this Taja. Taja. Who are you, Taja? Avoid the bars. Okay.
This creature's misery. May this serve as a lesson to all who wield the Tide Mother's gifts.
And that's the last one I want to do. Over here.
You're a long way from home. We will make this
fight. Speak to Collector Kojo Amamoko. Champions of Azeroth is getting on up there towards Exhaust. Exhaust. Spike and Jim, mech and pirate. Fire, Jaws, Bat, Bat, Wisp, Fire, Wisp, Spike. Brennadon. Alright. Is there anything I want to do in Dressbar? Oh yeah. Just that one. Oh, I think I get war resources. Yep, 200 war resources.
You're a long way from home.
1500 storm wake. Rip.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take my midday break early. I got some severe abdominal pains going on. Driving me crazy. Very uncomfortable. So, let's go turn this one quest into Bronzebeard. I'm at 10:08:32.
Azeroth cries out in pain. Remember your duty, Azeroth.
12:02:32. So I got 1,400. 1,400 Azeroth power, artifact power. Artifact power from Azeroth. I guess that's the correct terminology.
This one's good to hear, mate. Appreciate your patronage.
Okay. I hope to be back in a couple hours. Hopefully things will get better. Those of you who watch me on YouTube and my YouTube subscribers, thank you very much. I'll see you in the next video.